Well, 5 years after Katrina, City Hall has new leadership now. Mayor Mitch Landrieu took the oath of office in May, and he faces some big challenges, including a major budget hole. I sat down with the mayor at City Hall and began by asking him how he measures progress.
Because you have to take stock of where you are. You know, one of the things that we do particularly well here when we're having a good time is forget about, you know, being honest about exactly where we were. And you can look at the crime level. You can look at how many potholes we have. You can see measurable demonstrations of our failure or our success. And so what you want to do is get a baseline. And then we have to say where we want to be. And then we got to figure out how to get there. And that's the hard work of governing. Really tough decisions that have to be made on the budget, tough decisions on how to set priorities, tough decisions on whether we can reorganize the mousetrap of government, whether we can create in this city the ability for people to talk in a way so that we can find higher common ground. These public meetings that we're having are becoming really clear. People want the city to be safe. They want the police department that they can trust. They want streetlights that work. They want streets that are, you know, easy to ride on. They want to make sure that now we look forward on the issue of blight and start protecting the people that are here and their property values and the neighborhoods that we all live in. I think that's one of the great lessons of Katrina. One of the great successes has been the growth of the neighborhood organizations, civic communities, the coming together of faith-based organizations and not-for-profits and a different way of dealing with each other.
Now, you were here during the storm, and after it, you experienced everything the rest of us experienced. Where are we now as compared to where you thought we'd be 5 years later?
Well, I'm really impatient, and I don't think we're nearly as far along as I would have liked to have been. I'm very unhappy about the current financial situation in the city of New Orleans. Every time we have to go back and fix a $67 million budget hole means that we have to look backwards rather than forward. And so that's very frustrating. We should be much, much further along on that particular issue. I think the rebuilding has gone slower than I wanted it to. Some of it has to do with what happened in City Hall, but some of it also has to do with our relationship with FEMA and with the Louisiana Recovery Authority. That mechanism to move money to the ground quicker has got to be better as well.
Were people in New Orleans after the storm misled into thinking that this city could be as big as it was pre-Katrina?
You know, it's hard to, when you use the word where they misled, it's as though there was just one person who would say that you could. I think that people have a lot of hopes and dreams, you know, and when you're in trauma and you're in agony, the only thing you want to do is grab what you knew. And what you knew is what it was like, you know, before. I tell the story often about being in a boat rescuing folks, and on the St. Claude Bridge, a lady in the lower nine was holding a clock. And I said, babe, why are you holding that clock? She goes, well, I lost my house. I lost everything. And I said, yeah, but why are you holding that clock? She goes, because I don't know anything, but because I have this clock, I know what time it is. Which was a really poignant moment for me because she didn't want to let go of the thing that she knew was true. I don't think that New Orleans is going to have 500,000 people living here in a year. But I do think that in year 2018, if we do what we're supposed to do, there's no reason why New Orleans can't be another major American city.